good in the world. Music education, and patience that it takes to play the instrument that he plays. I can't say enough about how proud I am to share the stage tonight with the one and only Yo-Yo Ma.
Okay, so we're gonna be listening to Yo-Yo Ma and Chris Botti. So today we are listening to Yo-Yo Ma and Chris Botti. Okay, so today I started, I actually changed my YouTube name from Nephews to The Human Experience. And basically what's going to be happening is I'll be doing live videos. I'm going to be doing more live videos on YouTube though than on Instagram. But I figured let me start on Instagram and then I'll go on YouTube tomorrow. So follow my YouTube channel, link down below. And then you can get notifications on my YouTube channel when I do go live. But this segment, The Human Experience, basically I feel like we are spiritual beings. We are spiritual beings experiencing humanity, and it's very relevant that we realize that, because if we don't realize that we are just experiencing humanity, and that we are higher than, you know, than this, then that's how we fall into depression, you know, because we don't know how to handle our humaneness. So I'll be talking about that, basically relating it to like the Bible, because I feel like the Bible is like the ultimate psychology book, you know, like you can never go wrong with the Bible. So I do think that when we can take lessons, like the basic principles that the Bible is trying to tell us, to teach us, so that we can actually be able to experience, you know, humanity the way that we intended to. And so like today I was just like going through Psalms, and like Psalm 5, I don't know, like it just spoke to me. So like I'll just be reading it and just explaining how, like how it affects us as humans, like what it says to me, actually, like how I understand it. So I am recording all my lives, so this live will definitely go up on my Instagram. So listen to what Psalm 5 says. Give ear to my words, O Lord. Consider my meditation. Hearken unto the voice of my cry, my King and my God, for unto thee will I pray. Like, that's how we always want to be, like, with God. We always have to, you know, consult with God, consult with ourselves, like, be on that honest plane with ourselves, you know. Imagine just like being in constant meditation, like talking to God, you know, talking to your higher self, trying to figure out, like, yo, what is this? The human experience, right? But listen, like, plead with God, man. Plead with God to, like, listen to that still small voice that is constantly trying to talk to you and you are constantly shutting it down. Like, listen to that still small voice. My voice shalt thou hear in the morning, O Lord. In the morning will I direct my prayer unto thee and will look up. For thou art not a God that hath pleasure in wickedness, neither shall evil dwell with thee. The foolish shall not stand in thy sight. Thou hatest all workers of iniquity. Thou shalt destroy them that speak leasing. The Lord will abhor the bloody and deceitful man. But as for me, I will come into thy house in the multitude of thy mercy, and in thy fear will I worship towards thy holy temple. Hero. This is not even done, but like the way you have to be honest with God, you know, like understand the truth. Like, there's a truth, right? And there's like the lies that you're trying to feed yourself. You know, there's like the truth and then there's the lies. It's like you are your own worst enemy, right? But listen to this. Lead me, O Lord, in thy righteousness. Oh, let me play some yo-yo ma there. Lead me, O Lord, in thy righteousness because of mine enemies. Make thy way straight before my face. Sure, like, when I read this, when it says, lead me, O Lord, in thy righteousness because of mine enemies, I always figure, like, we're always thinking that enemies is other people, but, like, we can be our own enemies, you know what I mean? We can be our own enemies, like, and that is where we actually need to put the focus on, because you can't control how other people, like, react, how other people behave, but you can always control how you behave and how you react to certain things. So, like, whenever you're thinking about enemies, whenever I'm thinking about enemies now, like, it's not about, like, other people. Like, other people are not your enemies. You are your own worst enemy. I am my own worst enemy. And as long as I can know that, you know, and acknowledge that, you know, that's how, like, you start taking responsibility and, like, ownership, right? Like, you know what, actually I need to grow up and, like, mature in your thinking, because you're always maturing. You cannot always say that, oh no, I've matured is enough, you know what I mean? Like, think I've done all the maturing. That's how you become complacent and, you know, believe in your own lies, like your own fantasies, right? So I feel like just talking about the human experience, it kind of like teaches you that you are in control of how you react, of how you respond to things. You are in control of that. You can never be in control of how someone will react to things, or how, like, you know, the people around you are actually behaving or treating you, or like, you can never be in control of that. So you have to always think, no, actually, I am my own worst enemy for even allowing that to happen, you know, for allowing like that person, or, you know, that situation to take hold of like your mind, you know. And you are in control of how you react. You are in control. So every time, right, you make a mistake, you have to own up to your own mistake. Because if you don't own up to your own mistake, then you are going to be stuck in that same space without actually moving forward. You know what I mean? So you need to always just be like honest with yourself. Take ownership of whatever mistake that you make. Take ownership of it. Listen to this. For there is no faithfulness in their mouth. Their inward part is very wickedness. Their throat is a open sepulchre. I wonder what that word is. They flatter with their tongue. Like you know, you always think like people, you know, can have like influence over you and everything, but at the end of the day, right, you have influence over yourself way more. So it's not about like, you know, like, oh no, like, you know, that person, you know, or that situation, actually, like, no, it's all about like, what are you able to, you know, convince yourself, what are you able to make sense of, right? And that is basically like, you know, the human experience. Because you are basically your own judge and jury. You are. Because at the end of the day, it's you who allows like the things to affect you. Like how things affect you. You have control over that. You have control over that. So I think the best thing, like whenever like you're thinking of like, oh, enemies and everything like that, you should always think of like yourself first, because you are your own worst enemy. Okay. Destroy thou them, O God. I'm reading from the King James Version, hey? Bear with me. Destroy thou them, O God. Let them fall by their own counsel. Cast them out in the multitude of their transgressions, for they have rebelled against thee. Like, whatever you decide, whatever you counsel yourself, you will reap the benefits of the counsel that you are giving yourself. So if you gave yourself a bad counsel, right, you are going to reap the benefits of that bad counsel. And I think it is very important that when you do realize it, you don't start like dwelling in the fact that, oh my gosh, yeah, that counsel was wrong and everything, like, because you give yourself the most counsel, right? Like, not people, you give yourself the most counsel. So you need to always be aware of how you are counseling yourself. and always, if it's a bad council, you always want that council to like come crumbling down as quickly as possible, because the longer it drags on, I feel the more dire like the consequences of that council. So it's better you realize, you know, how bad the council is, and you learn from that council, like, that was bad, that was a bad decision, or that was a bad council, and then you move on to next steps. You're like, okay, so what is next? What can I do next? You know what I'm saying? Because if you get stuck in that, you know, self-loathing, self-hating stage, you are going to fall into a deep depression, and you do not want that. But let all those that put their trust in thee rejoice. Let them ever shout for joy, because thou defendest them. Let them also that love thy name be joyful in thee. For thou, Lord, wilt bless the righteous. With favor wilt thou compass him as with a shield. So every time we actually trust in the counsel of God, in the counsel of, like, you know, your higher self, every time you trust in that counsel, you will reap the positive benefits of that, because usually it is always positive. It is only when you try to use your, you know, your human experience or what you understand about, like, you know, the experience that you're going through to make counsel, like, if that's all you are using, then you are not giving yourself good counsel. You need to always, I feel like, refer to the Bible. Actually, I freaking believe that so much, that the Bible definitely helps us, like, get through the human experience, you know, like, as humans, we have to experience a lot of trials, but, like, also, you cannot just give up on being, like, human, right? You still have to live this life, so you want to live it the best way possible. And the best way possible is through understanding humanity. It's through understanding the experience that you are going through, and knowing that you are not that experience. You are so much more. You are on a journey. Yeah. So make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel, The Human Experience, down below. Link is in my bio. I will be doing my lives on YouTube starting tomorrow. This is a moonlight sonata. David cries unto the Lord for mercy. David cries unto the Lord for mercy. He asks to be healed and saved. How often, like, do we do that, you know? O Lord, rebuke me not in thine anger, neither chasten me in thy heart's displeasure. Yo, like, you don't want God to, like, rebuke you in anger, hey? Because when God rebukes you in anger, hey, it's not for the faint of heart. It is not. O Lord, rebuke me not in thine anger, neither chasten me in thy heart's displeasure. Like, you always want God to teach you gently. But I also feel like it gets to a point where sometimes God just has to, you know, snap us out of it. Like, snap out of it, you know? But you don't want that. You don't want that. But I do feel like every one of us has gone through that, where you felt like, yo, God is angry with me. Yeah, right? But I do believe that when you learn your lesson, that's like the only way that you can actually, you know, move forward. Have mercy upon me, O Lord, for I am weak. O Lord, heal me, for my bones are vexed. You know, when you know, like, where you can always tend to for comfort, and like, I feel like God has given us that space, you know, like, you can always come to me for comfort. Whatever it is that you are going through, you can always go to him for comfort. And like, he will always comfort you. He will always comfort you. But the one thing that, you know, that I've learned is, when you own up to what you did wrong, when you learn that lesson, you are able to move on from it. But if you don't, you're gonna keep repeating the same cycles over and over again. Listen, my soul is also so vexed. But thou, O Lord, how long? You always want him, you know, like, to come rescue you as quickly as possible. Because, you know, he is the only one that can save you. So whenever you are making a decision, you need to always consult with God. Like, God, what are the consequences of making this decision? Return, O Lord, deliver my soul, or save me for thy mercy's sake. We always, like, run, like, you know, like, please show me mercy, please show me mercy. But that's the thing. Like, whenever you go to him, he is always like, you are welcome, my child. Like, you can come here any time. I don't care. I don't care, like, what, you know, your enemy is trying to convince you, right? Because we are our own worst enemy, so we all have, like, different struggles that we go through, right? Like psychologically. So that enemy that is your personal one, you need to overcome that. And the only way to overcome that is by, you know, immersing yourself in and the scriptures in the word, because the word, you know, is truth. So whenever you always referring back to truth, you always know that, you know, you won't go wrong. So always refer to truth. For in death there is no remembrance of thee. In the grave, who shall give thee thanks? You give worship, you give thanks. Like now, when you are going through life, that this is what you have to do to fully experience life, you know? But also knowing that you are a spiritual being, having the human experience, it is not for a very long time, but the time that you are here, you need for it to have meaning. You know, you need to learn something, because how then do you gain eternal life if you don't understand eternal life? You know, I am weary with my groanings. All the night make I my bed to swim. I water my couch with my tears. Mine eye is consumed because of grief. It waxeth old because of all mine enemies. All the enemies are in your head. All the enemies is yourself. And you need to overcome that. You need to overcome that to make sense of the human experience. Yeah. Wow. Listen to this. Depart from me, all ye workers of iniquity. You have to be speaking to yourself. Like, you cannot think this is other people, or like, you know, you don't really take responsibility. You have to know that you are talking to yourself, that you are your own worst enemy. So when you are saying, depart from me, all you workers of iniquity, you are basically silencing those thoughts, right? Those negative thoughts. That is you silencing them. Like, depart from me, all you workers of iniquity. For the Lord hath heard the voice of my weeping. The Lord hath heard my supplication. The Lord will receive my prayer. Let all mine enemies be ashamed and sore vexed. Let them return and be ashamed suddenly. Like, for you to actually like ask that of God, like, you know, let all mine enemies be ashamed. Like, if you want your own enemies to, like, you know, depart from you, you are basically challenging yourself to get rid of, you know, those bad habits that you do have. You are challenging yourself. This is not like for like, oh, other people. No, this is for yourself, because you do this to yourself. It's not, you know, the people that you hang with or whatever. They can have, you know, they can like have an influence on you, but you determine how deep that influence goes. You determine it. So basically, you are your own worst enemy. You are your own judge and jury. So you always need to be aware of like where your thought process is going, because you need to kill those bad habits that you do have. You need to kill them You know? So I truly believe that when we are reading the Bible, it's not like about some like other people or whatever. It is about us, the things that we allow,
Words,
the things
performance,
that
rules
we
of
give
behavior,
way to, you
and not
know?
the greatest
It is
human
about us. It is not about other
in
people.
history.
It is
The
always
reason
about
people throw
us.
away,
So you
and this is
always,
for
always need
get
to
under my
check
hood,
in
anybody
with
call me.
ourselves, be honest with ourselves, learn from our mistakes. There is no use dwelling, you know, there is no use dwelling
His
in
music will live forever, and we are gonna
the
play
wrong things
our
that you
pieces
did. There is
in
no use in
paradise.
doing that. You are just, you know, digging yourself deeper into depression. Where else you should actually be like saying, oh yeah, you know what? I messed up. But His grace is sufficient for the mess up that I did. It's all about learning. Never let like something happen like twice. You know what I mean? It's all about learning. It is all about learning. And realizing that you don't know everything, you don't know anything, you know? But anyways, thank you guys so much for joining. I'm gonna post this on my Instagram as well.